Praise be to Jesus. Welcome back to part 2 of lesson 10, the Pilgrim Church. Let's begin with a small prayer. Let's all rise, join our hands, close our eyes. Lord God, Almighty Father, we praise you, we give you thanks, we glorify your name. Lord Jesus, be with us today in this class. Help us to understand your teaching. Holy Spirit, guide us through this lesson. Mother Mary, pray for us. We make this prayer to Christ our Lord. Amen. So in the part 1 of lesson 10, we learned that we are a pilgrim community, a pilgrim church, and we are on a journey, on a pilgrimage to heaven on this earth. We are not going to stay on this earth forever. It is God's will that man should die. But then we learned that death is actually a gateway to eternity. It is a Passover or a passage from what is mortal to what is immortal. Now let's try to learn the part 2 of lesson 10, where we see the final judgment and the individual judgment. So what happens when we die? When we die, a soul is separated from the body, and the body is left behind on this earth to decay and join back to dust. So every year we celebrate Ash Wednesday, that is in Latin Church, or Ash Monday in our Zero Malabar Church. That is the very next day of Petrata Sunday. And on that day, we remind ourselves that we are dust, and to dust we shall return. So priest will make the sign of cross on our forehead with the ash. All of you remember, right? And why does the priest do so? It is to remind us that we are all made from dust, and one day we are going to return back to dust. So that is what we try to remember on Ash Monday. Now, what happens to the soul when we die? The soul is subjected to judgment. The moment we die, the soul appears before God, face to face with God. And according to our life, our conduct on this earth, how we have lived, our soul will be judged by God. And we may attain any one of the state, that is a state of salvation, which is heaven, or the state of punishment, which is hell, or the state of purification, which is purgatory. And apart from the individual judgment, we also have a final judgment. And that is when the just and the unjust people, that is the good people and the bad people, are going to be separated. So in the lesson, we read that there are two kinds of judgments. One is individual judgment, and another is final judgment. Now, what is the final judgment? It is the act of God which glorifies the just and punishes the unjust. And this final judgments is an eternal act wherein the just are called to heaven to live eternally with the Almighty in union with Jesus Christ, and the unjust is pushed down to punishment, to hell. We can read lot of verses in the Bible where we come across the prophecy that Jesus Christ is going to come again to this world for his final judgment. So when we pray the Apostles' Creed, when we profess our faith, I believe, we have these verses. He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again to judge the living and the dead. So we proclaim that there is going to be a second coming of Jesus Christ, where he is going to do the final judgment and separate the just and the unjust. Now, what is hell? As I told you before, it is a state, right? Hell is nothing but eternal punishment. It is a state where we live away from God. On this earth, if we are submitting our lives to the slavery of sin and we deliberately opt against God and his teachings, then we are bound to be punished and bound to be put into eternal punishment, that is hell. Now we should know that hell and heaven are both eternal. So depending on our conduct on this earth, we are going to attain either hell or heaven or purgatory. Now what is purgatory? Purgatory is a state of purification. In Syrian language, it is called Bespukana. It means the house of salvation. Now, there may be people who have a conversion of their heart and they confess their sins just before their death, and they turn themselves to the mercy of God, and such people are going to go into a state which is called purgatory, and they need a state of purification, a time of purification, so that they can attain the divine love required to achieve heaven. They are not pure enough to enter heaven, so they need our help, the people who are living on this earth. So every year we celebrate, or we have a day called All Souls Day. On this day we pray for the departed souls of our near and dear ones. I hope all of you are aware of that. We pray that their souls may rest in peace and they attain the eternal glory, and they are in the house of God in union with Jesus Christ in heaven. So the prayer of the living, especially the Eucharist and also the sacrifices and almsgiving, will help the soul or souls which are in the state of purification in purgatory to attain the eternal glory and eternal life in heaven. What is heaven? Heaven is a place where we live with peace and happiness in union with Jesus Christ. So it is a place for the just, for good people who have lived their life on this earth, helping others, making sacrifices for others. Heaven is the final goal of every believer, and it is this hope of attaining heaven that gives meaning to Christian life. As we read in the lesson where we learned about the sharing church. So we learned how, what motivates the believers or what motivates the Christians to share with other people. It is this hope of eternal life, a hope of heavenly life with Lord Jesus Christ, with union with Lord Jesus Christ. And it is only through Jesus Christ that we can attain eternal glory and we can enter the kingdom of God. Jesus Christ opened the doors of the heaven. The day He died on the cross, He opened the doors of heaven for each and every living being on this earth. And He told us that it is only through Him that we can reach heaven. Through Him and in Him. It means that if we live a life according to His will, and He showed us how to live a life of love and empathy and sacrifice for others, service for others, and if we live a life according to God's will, as Jesus lived on this earth, we all can attain eternal glory and live eternal life in heaven. And of course, heaven, it's a spiritual life. There is no importance or no significance for the physical life. And we are not going to experience any of our physical needs like hunger or thirst, nothing. Because there's no place for materials in heaven. It's only a spiritual life. We are not going to take anything physical with us to heaven. So as Christians and as believers, it should be our ultimate aim to reach heaven as we complete this pilgrimage on this earth. And how we can attain that goal is by doing good works. Living a life of sacrifice and service, moved by faith and love. And the Holy Spirit, the helper sent by Jesus Christ, will help us to live a life of good deeds and good conduct, moved by faith and love. So let's conclude this lesson and take a resolution that we will pray for the departed soul, and we will also make this journey, this pilgrimage on this earth, fruitful one, so that we all can attain heaven and eternal glory. Let's conclude this class with a prayer. Let's all rise, close our eyes, join our hands. Lord God, Almighty Father, we praise You, we give You thanks. Lord Jesus, by Your mercy, may the departed soul rest in peace. Help us to live a life of good works and good deeds, so that we may also attain the eternal glory. Holy Spirit, help us to live according to Your promptings. Mother Mary, pray for us to Your Son, Jesus Christ. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Praise be to Jesus.